Hello dear all, so in this lecture we discuss third chapter from Robert's philosophy, that is the concept of vital force. So let's see how Dr. Robert teaches us the concept of vital force. So first point is consider about importance of philosophy. Materia medica is indeed important for the practice of homeopathy, and its thorough comprehension and study is needed at all the times. But unless the homeopathic physician has a concept of philosophy of the reasons underlying the administration of the remedy, he will never make a careful homeopathic physician, and he may not become a successful homeopathic physician practitioner. So materia medica is of course important, but besides his knowledge of materia medica, physician must have learned the principles of homeopathy, which will teach him the scope and limitations of homeopathy, the remedy reactions interpretations in homeopathy, the knowledge of second prescription, knowledge of posology. This he will achieve only when he learns philosophy. So in order to understand homeopathy and to get the proper concept of administering our remedies and even of taking the case and eliciting symptoms, we must get Hahnemann's concept of the principles that enter into the studies of homeopathic physician. So we want to understand what is homeopathy. So and for that purpose, we have to learn the concept of judicious administration of our remedies and how to do the case taking and how to analyze the symptoms, how to evaluate the symptoms. So for this purpose, we want to learn Hahnemann's concept of the principles, so that the homeopathic physician is successful in his practice. Successful is equal to about the cure he can obtain while treating his patients. One of the first and foremost elements with which the homeopathic physician must be conversant is the different forms of energy. For it is on this basis only that we can prescribe homeopathically. So the first step to understand homeopathy is to understand the concept of energy and its various forms. The concept of energy and then vital energy is the foundation of homeopathy. So let's see how this concept of energy and then vital energy is discussed. In the healthy condition of man, the spirit-like vital force, the dynamic that animates the material body, rules with unbounded sway and retains all the parts of the organism in admirable, harmonious vital operations as regards both sensations and functions, so that our indwelling, reason-gifted mind can freely employ this living, healthy instrument for the higher purpose of existence. So this is the concept of vital force discussed in the aphorism 9 of Organon of Medicine, 6th edition. So this spirit-like vital force is governing our healthy instrument, our body. this living healthy instrument for the higher purpose of our existence. So the concept of spirit-like vital force is introduced from the aphorism number 9. So this animates the material body. That means it imparts life to this material body. Material body made up of cells, tissues, organs, muscles, bones, etc. So vital force imparts life into this material body, and its most important function is self-preservation. Through this vital operation, the living organism experiences sensations and functions. This indwelling means it is in the living beings, it is in the living in the body. So this indwelling reason gifted mind can freely employ this living healthy instrument for the higher purpose of existence. So the all these metabolic phenomena which takes place in the body are due to the vital operations. Various vital operations takes place in the various organs, and all the functioning of the organs is kept in harmony. So they are related with each other in harmonious way. So the concept is explained in this 9th aphorism, concept of vital force. And then the name is changed to vital energy. Further explained is the concept of trinity of life. Trinity of life is nothing but body, mind and spirit or soul. We recognize life in three parts: the body, the mind and the spirit. This is a trinity, and this trinity is always present in all life and in some form in every part of our organism. These forces react in sympathy and are interdependent. So we recognize life. So when we ask what is life, so life is not just the material body, but this life is in the three parts: the body, mind and the spirit. So the body, that is his material existence, mind is the dynamic existence, and the spirit. The spirit means the energy, the vital energy which is present in all the living organisms. This is a trinity, and this trinity is always present in all life and in some form in every part of our organism. These forces react in sympathy and are interdependent. So this trinity is present in all the lives and in some form in every part of organism. So in every tissues and in every cells. So concept of life, body, mind and spirit is nothing but altogether is the vital force which governs this material body. So life is trinity, body, mind and spirit, and this is the functioning of vital force or vital energy. Now, where is this life present? In the body? Is it in the brain? Is it in the heart? So life is present in every cell. No organ, no tissue, no cell, no molecule is independent of the activities of the others. But the life of each one of these elements is merged into the life of the whole. The unit of human life cannot be the organ, the tissue, the cell, the molecule, the atom, but the whole organism and the whole man. So the human life is present in the whole organism, whole man, as well as in the every cell. So the human life, life is not equal to organ, tissue or cell, but this life exists in the every cell in the form of vital energy. So vital force materializes into the cell. It has within itself the power to develop muscle, nerve, brain cells, individual in themselves, gifted with the powers for specialized uses in the future. Without this vital energy, the cell or the whole body becomes inanimate and is dead. It is only when the vital energy is present that there is a living organism capable of physical action and of the exercise of mental powers and the ability to take hold on the spiritual forces. So, this life force, this power, it is within itself the power to develop the muscle. So the power is the dynamic energy, and it gets materialized in the muscle, nerve, brain cells. Without this vital energy, there is no sensation and there is no life, and the organism is dead. No two individuals are alike. The development of vital energy in one differs from that in another. So no two individuals are alike. So the development of vital energy is different from each individual. The growth and development of each individual progresses as it draws upon the physical energy and upon the dynamic energy as it manifests in the brain and upon the spiritual energy. So the growth and development is the most important feature of the living organism. So how does it get its energy for growth and development and repair? That it draws this energy. So this energy which is drawn is from the energy, that is the from the universe. So this energy we call it as a spiritual energy or dynamic energy. When the energy functions properly in all the three manifestations, the whole personality grows harmoniously. So the energy is functioning in all the three aspects, that is mind, body and soul. The whole personality grows harmoniously. Harmony, that is the balance which is maintained between the functioning of various organs. And how does this harmony is maintained? It is because of the action of vital force or vital energy. This energy is the powerhouse that supplies the impetus of growth for the whole economy, the whole individual. So how does this dynamic energy is giving the power to the power is received in the individual, and this energy is the powerhouse that supplies the energy for the growth. The growth is resulted in the entire economy and the whole individual. When the energy functions improperly, there is greater growth on one plane than on another, and the personality is not symmetrical, and there is imbalance and harmony is lost. Any disturbance of this vital energy or force results in a disfigured or disturbed development of the whole human economy. So, the disturbance of the vital energy results in the disturbance of the whole human economy. The metabolism is disturbed. So, we understood that the play of the vital energy present in every cell, every tissue, organ, and the whole organism. And if harmony is maintained, the patient or the individual is in the state of health. And this individual is called as patient when he develops the symptoms which are of the disharmony. These disease symptoms show themselves in unified order in the physical, mental, and spiritual spheres. But each individual does not show necessarily disturbance in all these spheres in manifesting diseased conditions. So, the affection of vital force is called as disease, and these symptoms show themselves in unified order in the physical, mental, and spiritual planes. And each individual does not show necessary disturbance in all these spheres at a time in manifesting disease conditions. So, few patients may have the disturbance only at the mind level. Few patients may have at the level, body level, or few patients may have disturbance both at mental or physical level. So, vital force in health and disease, we already saw the functioning of vital force. It is part of energy present in every cell, in every organ, and entire organism. So, the balance is maintained of the functioning of various organs called as harmony. It is in the state of health. If this harmony is lost, there are various symptoms in the three spheres, that is of the mind or body or the spirit. So, actually practical purpose, we consider the symptoms are in the mind and body and not in the spirit. So, the symptoms are considered, measured as a disturbance of mind and body. The influence of this vital force on the whole organism is so delicately adjusted and so intimately connected with every part that seemingly distant organs or unrelated symptoms show the effects of any disturbance of the vital force. The appearance of these disturbances is a reflection of the inward turmoil and confusion of the harmonious action which the vital force has suffered. So, appearance of such symptoms, such disturbing symptoms, such disharmony is a reflection of some turmoil inside and the confusion of the harmony, and this is the reflection that vital force is affected. So, vital force is an expression of the disturbed vital energy and is a manifestation of the man as a unit and not the separate parts of the body. So, in the diseased condition, there is disturbed vital energy and it is a manifestation of the man as a unit. So, we don't consider in homeopathy that the liver is damaged or the lungs are affected. What we consider, the individual as a whole is affected. So, not his parts only, So entire living organism is affected because of the disturbance of the vital energy, which may be reflected in the altered function of any organ. That brings us to the point of looking upon disease as a dynamic expression of the disturbance of the harmony and rhythm of vital energy. So, very important aspect that disease is dynamic disturbance of vital energy, and there is disharmony and there are disagreeable sensations and functions. So vital force is manifested in disease now, as it naturally develops because of disturbed vital force, and it develops also in the disturbed vital force from the proving of remedies, showing the action of remedies and the very nature of the remedies themselves. This is the reason why the remedies are potentized, so that they may reach more surely the vital energy of the individual. So when this is achieved, the remedies are potentized, and if they are matched with the symptoms of the patient under the principle of similia, there is cure is obtained. So the vital energy is also present in every drug substance, and this energy which is hidden in the drug substance is brought forward by the process of potentization. Action of proven remedy and action of disease. The action of the proven remedy is similar to the action of disease from whatever source. The material organism without the vital force is capable of no sensation, no function, no self-preservation. It derives all the sensations and performs all the functions of the life solely by means of the immaterial being, the vital force, which animates the material organism in health and disease. So when the vital force is functioning in harmony, the person experiences sense of health. But when this harmony is lost, there are some different abnormal sensations patient experiences. This is the state of disease. So where the vital force is dynamically affected or deranged. Now these disease conditions needs to be treated so that the vital energy which is dynamically disturbed is restored again. So what is the type of treatment for disease condition? The easiest way to deal with the sickness is to give medicines in a antipathy or mechanical treatment which puts a stop to the symptoms. So simple, if patient is having constipation, the medicine is given which produces diarrhea. However, this is more upset of the vital force. That means what? First of all, in the state of disease, vital force is deranged, and the antipathic treatment, if given, it still more upsets the vital force, as there is suppression of the individual expression of the disordered vital energy. It may be done by sprays, it may be done by ointment, it may be done by irritative or narcotic treatment. This treatment does not reach affected vital force to bring about cure. So the cure cannot be obtained by such antipathic method. or by the methods which removes the expressions of disease, by ointments or by sprays or by cauterization. This causes the suppression of the expressed vital energy. So the suppressive treatment is very commonly practiced in the diseased condition. So the vital energy in the state of disease expresses itself into some symptoms which are altered. Now, how to correct them? If you take this easier method of giving antipathy or local application, the patient may be temporarily relieved, but the cure is not obtained. So suppressive treatment is usually practiced in disease condition by the old school method. As against this, now Dr. Hahnemann advocates the use of the homeopathic medicines, that is similar medicines whose action is known beforehand, and these medicines are also dynamic in nature. These medicines are dynamic in nature. The hidden energy is brought forward by the process of potentization. So this was about the introduction of vital force in the Robert's philosophy. So the vital force is the part of the energy, the vital energy in the universe, and it is present in each and every cell of the whole organism. Thank you.